Hello YouTube friends, today Ramon here. In this video I'm going to benchmark Agents of Mayhem on a single GTX 1070 paired with an Intel Core i7-860. The video is recorded on an external recorder, so what you will see in this video will be pure performance as always. The CPU is overclocked to 4 GHz, normal overclocking speed for this system. We will see that more clearly in game. It just jumps up and down in desktop. 12 GB of system RAM, and the graphics card is a GTX 1070 made by KFA2. It is the EX model, latest NVIDIA firmware installed, and let me overclock it a bit. It will be boosting at 2 GHz with the setting I just did. So that's it. I'm going to use Fraps to collect frame rate data from my custom gameplay session. We will see the basic result in this file and some analysis with FLAT at the end of the video, and a very interesting comparison with the Coffee Lake Core i5-8600K. Okay, the game has loaded. It loads straight into the headquarters, so I can show you the settings straight away. I'm going to use the high preset, although the GTX 1070 can handle the ultra preset just fine. However, I don't want to make this absolutely GPU limited. I want the settings to be just a little relaxed in order to better highlight any difference that may arise between various CPUs. I will be doing ultra preset, of course, on better video cards to compare with a GTX 1070. I have already uploaded a GTX 1070 ultra preset with a Coffee Lake CPU. I will put the relevant description, the relevant link in the end of the video. These are the settings that the high preset sets: 1080p resolution, of course. Also, I have imposed a frame rate limit of 120 frames per second, because there is just one single scene that produces a very high frame rate, and I want to avoid that. It will not affect the benchmark at all. It does not run that high anyhow. It goes up to 100 frames per second maximum. Okay, this scene is just the loading screen. It is very light, it does not count. You will see in game that it does not go up to 120 frames per second. I'm not going to start a benchmark just yet, and
keep your eyes up, really.
The lady for the mission arrives.
As an immunologist, I was a hunter.
Rama, are you there?
Of course, Friday.
I'm starting the benchmark.
Or your car. I enjoy a nice luxury sedan, but with quarter mile, who knows? You might get stuck with a pickup truck. I've updated your SIN with a location. Head there. I'll give details on the way.
Ah, I see the AR beacon now. So, what is going on?
We have reason to believe that Legion's Ministry of Pride is far more embedded in Seoul than we initially suspected.
Oh? How so?
Well, that's exactly what we need you to find out. We know Babylon is in town, but who else? And why are they here? I need you to crack into some access points we have identified and feed me some data.
I can do that. But tell me something, Friday. Why did you pick me for this task?
Persephone chose you, actually. She said you were the only one for the job.
And where is our illustrious leader currently?
Just establish a connection to your SIM, hack through the security protocol, and I'll handle the rest.
Sending you the data currently.
Uh-oh. Rama, I see Legion forces headed to your area.
I see them, Friday.
You'll need to stay close to the access point. Stray too far and your comm signal becomes too weak to carry the data.
Yeah.
Nicely done. I've updated your location with another access point. While you head there, I'll work on decrypting this.
Friday, may I ask you something?
Of course.
I've been an agent for some time now. I was, after all, one of the first to join.
And your service has been exemplary.
But I did not join Mayhem to hunt down Persephone's old friends. I am here to save the people of Mumbai.
I see what you're getting at, Rama, but our current objective is finding Dr. Babylon. In Seoul.
But the plague is in Mumbai.
I understand. I can talk to Persephone.
Thank you, but I am perfectly capable of speaking to her myself.
Of course. As you wish.
I suppose I'll just stay here then.
It appears this time the surveillance device is a cherry tree.
At least they're utilizing the natural environment, yeah? Uh-oh.
Let me guess. More Legion interference.
Exactly. You know what to do.
This is the scene I told you about that I want to skip, but it stays at 120 frames per second, so it will not destroy my benchmark. Otherwise, it produces a frame rate of crazy numbers, and the variability of the frame rate goes way up and messes up with my measurement. It is a good way to avoid such things from happening.
Everything. Give me a moment to look this over. Oh, and I'll send you the location of the next access point.
While you do that, be a dear and put Persephone on the line.
Oh, well, I'll see if she's busy.
She is not too busy, Friday. Not for me.
I'll, let her know.
Rama, you summoned me.
It appears as though you have forgotten our deal, Persephone.
Our deal?
I have always been directed. I joined Mayhem only so I might find the cause of the plague ravaging my homeland. And in the years since, I have gone on numerous missions for your causes. But you? You have not held up your end of the bargain.
Is that right?
It is. And I would appreciate if you did not act so coy about this.
Well then, Rama, I apologize if I seem coy. But I've been doing my best. It's not as though Legion publishes its information on some blog.
It is a good thing that we are not reliant on the internet for all our information.
Right now, Rama, I need you to do this. I am, after all, the one who signs your checks.
Yes, yes, you are. But we are not done talking about this.
You are correct, Rama. We are not.
I'll be right here.
I'm not gonna lie. You and Persephone? That was sort of awkward to listen to.
I am making a reminder that you are an eavesdropper. Friday, what am I looking at?
Oh, it's a spicy stir-fried rice cake. Quite delish, and very popular in Korea.
And you want me to stick my fingers in there to find your device?
Yes?
That was disgusting.
But your sacrifice in comfort will pay massive dividends, I promise. Oh, and Rama?
Legion troops, I know. Here I go again. The bigger, the better. You brought this upon yourself.
Feel the tension all the way over here.
Your boss is an infuriating woman, Friday.
You mean our boss?
Currently, yes, but perhaps not for long.
Oh, I see.
So, what...
Okay, this is the end of the benchmark. The average result was 76 frames per second. I think it is not much slower compared to the Coffee Lake system on the same settings with the same video card. We will see in a moment. We do have some stuttering here, however. This is the runtime of the game. We have 98, 97 percent GPU usage with some dips here and there, some more as you can see in some parts, so we have some performance lost as far as maximum GPU load goes, but the game is running nicely. The frame times are the ones that seem a little worrisome. I'm not sure how this will translate in flat, but we will see in a moment. The frame rate is okay, however, solidly above 60 frames per second, so we have a very good gaming experience. The CPU usage is interesting. It seems to be equally shared on all cores, both physical and logical. Medium to high, I would say, and as you can see, we have a very important measurement here. The CPU usage is solidly above 50%, meaning that all cores are doing very real work for the most part. So hyperthreading actually works and helps in this game. The CPU temps are okay. A couple of the cores got a little hotter, but they are still very much within reasonable temperatures. GPU temps also very good. RAM usage at 6.6 gigabytes. 2 gigahertz for the core clock throughout the run. No problems here. 2.5 gigabytes of video RAM usage. The game is not very heavy on the video RAM. It is very heavy on the processing power. CPU clock at 4 GHz, no problems. And let's see the ever important comparisons. First of all, I'm going to open the benchmark I just did on the 1070 with the i7-860. There we are. And I'm also going to open the GTX 970 on the i7-860, again at high setting. I have three benchmarks here, as you can see. The first one is the one I just did. The previous one was on the 970 and the other one was on the 7950 at medium preset. I want this one for the 970. I will put the relevant links, of course, at the end of the video. And the most important comparison of them all will be the one with the 8600K. Yes, this one should be a little tricky. I think I have to. What? Give me a moment, my friends. Okay, I have opened all my relevant benchmarks. I had renamed the Coffee Lakes benchmark and I had put the GTX 1070 in front of the file name. That's why I could not find the stupid benchmark. In any case, all relevant benchmarks are now loaded. 76 frames per second for the GTX 1070 with the Linfield, 88 frames per second for the Coffee Lake. A considerable difference, a little more stuttering, a little more variability. Overall, a good performance for the Linfield CPU, but let's see the analysis a little more clearly. Let me zoom out to the 60 millisecond threshold. It is hopeful from the start that we do not have a huge spike zooming out the whole frame times graph beyond, I don't know, 200 milliseconds. This happens sometimes in very long benchmarks like this one. Overall, the frame times are okay, meaning that most of them seem to be below the 16.7 milliseconds frame times. However, we do have quite a few spikes here and there, and some frame times are above 16 milliseconds. Let's remember how the Coffee Lake fared. For example, look at this spike here. It was one single spike, however, on the Coffee Lake system. Let me zoom into 60 milliseconds so we can see the difference more fairly. You can see that the Coffee Lake system does not exhibit these constant spikes in the frame times, meaning overall smoother gaming. I don't know why this thing happened here. The GTX 970, on the other hand, was pretty okay, to tell you the truth. Let's see. The GTX 970 seems to have better frame times for some strange reason compared to the GTX 1070. In any case, we will see in a moment. 53 frames per second with, yes, as you can see, the stuttering is indeed less on the GTX 970 on the same system. I'm using the latest build of the game on this run. I was using version 103 on the other two, 105 in this new benchmark. Supposedly it should be a little better, if anything, more optimized and whatnot, but I'm not sure if this is the problem. In any case, frame times beyond 16.7 milliseconds, as you can see, are a good 8.6%. Good, by good I mean bad, of course. We do not need these frame times, and a lot of them are above that. For the Coffee Lake system, as you can see, we had only 0.22 frame times beyond 16.7 milliseconds, much better performance. And for the GTX 970, they were 75%, a very different number, of course. The histogram of the frame times, not bad. We do have some scattering in the frame times, but most of them are below 16 milliseconds, so it is not all that bad. The Coffee Lake should be a little better. We can see that the big spike that occurred on the Coffee Lake run pushed the histogram graph on the left of the screen, but most of the frame times, first of all, the frame times are more closely packed together and in lower numbers too, lower milliseconds that is, so a better performance overall. The GTX 970, as you can see, produces an all over the place frame times performance, so it is not the smoothest experience you can get. Now let's see the three runs side by side, red, green, blue. Green being the fast system, the Coffee Lake with the GTX 1070. We can see clearly now that the thickness of the frame times of the Coffee Lake system are is much thinner. So we have less stuttering, better frame rates and better performance. The GTX 970 also has a thinner performance line, frame times line, but all this happen in higher frame times, so we have slower performance overall. The GTX 1070 can really benefit even the Core i7-860 in this game, even at high, let alone at ultra. The GTX 970 cannot do ultra at all for this game. The frame rate of the three runs, again, the clear winner is the Coffee Lake system. Min, max and averages. Better average and better minimum for the Coffee Lake system. Let's see the very important graph with a 1% loss and the 0.1% loss, however, and we can see that there is a significant difference. First of all, for the average, we have 16% performance difference. This is may not be huge, but if we go to 1% loss, we can see that this difference jumps to 26%. And for the 0.1% loss, it even goes up to 45%. This may not be too important, but while gaming, you can really perceive these small differences. They would jump up and down. Maybe I will need to do, I'm not sure if it will help, but I have my GTX 970 installed on the Coffee Lake at the moment. So maybe a new benchmark for the 970 would help us see if it can improve the 1% loss and the 0.1% loss even on the GTX 970. I will need to do some tests for sure, that is, on the GTX 970, but I'm not sure how I will catch up with all that, too many benchmarks. So variability in stuttering, the variability is less for all three runs compared to all three runs. The Coffee Lake is the least has the least variability and the least stuttering, of course. No, look at that, we do not have the least stuttering even on the GTX 1070. Actually, the 970 had better stuttering for the Core i7-860 system. This is really weird. I'm not sure if it is the new version that is doing that. No, Again, I'm being stupid. I used the same version for these two. So I'm not exactly sure what is going on here. The percentiles. The Coffee Lake with a 1070 are of course much better, much faster performance. The Core i7-860 is not doing too bad, however it is slower, 1 to 2 milliseconds compared to the Coffee Lake system. Time spent beyond chart does not help. And lastly, the three comparables. We can see that the Core i7-860, due to the stuttering and the variability and the lower performance overall, gives us a borderline 61 frames per second overall feel. The 8600K with the GTX 1070 are on a much more relaxed 73 frames per second, meaning we could have a more solid gaming experience. The GTX 970 was struggling to keep a decent performance, which is not bad, but you need 60 for smooth gameplay. 44 is not really that good, even for the GTX 970. In any case, this is the end of the video, my friends. Stay tuned for more Core i7-860 benchmarks with the GTX 1070. Thank you very much for watching. See you soon.